Good morning, South. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance with the South community.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America,
and to the Republic for which it stands,
one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We'll hear more from them later in the show. Good morning once again, and welcome to the Falcon Report for this Friday, the 12th of November, 2021. I'm Ibrahim Kadri.
And I'm Saeed Ali. An award-filled night dazzled SOTS academically achieved students this week. The Falcon Report's Aiden Dombrowski has the details.
Students of high academic caliber had their advanced placement achievements acknowledged this week. Entering South Hall at 6:45, the AP students, alongside their parents, were dressed for the occasion. Once in their seats, the families were greeted by our school's principal, Ms. Maureen Henry, alongside the assistant principal, Ms. Jacqueline Allen, along with South's department heads. As the award show began, the AP scholars were all recognized for their ability to achieve such high scores on the annual AP exams, with some students receiving the addition of honors and distinction for even higher scores.
We're very proud to honor our students who challenged themselves last year to take rigorous academic courses and scored very highly on their advanced placement exams.
Before the night came to a close, an extra two awards were handed out to the scholars who participated in and completed the AP seminar and research exams, recognizing their research talent in the capstone program. Congratulations to all award recipients. For the Falcon Report, I'm Aiden Dombrowski.
Last week, the Art Honor Society laid out the plans for their biggest kind act yet, Operation Gratitude. Under advisors Mrs. Roseanne Valetti and Mr. Edward Lee, Art Honor Society members committed to handing out candy to current military service members and veterans. Using treats from Halloween festivities, Art Honor Society members completed step one of their plan by collecting candy in an organized fashion, where active military service members enjoyed the sweet treats, a great addition to Kindness Week.
It's supposed to go to service members, active or retired service personnel.
Freshmen got a head start into college last week as they got fresh information regarding admissions. Class started off with students' guidance counselors and members of the senior class coming in to give college advice. As informative packets were given out, guidance counselors went over various high school's transcripts, comparing the various aspects that make students stand out. From this, freshmen gathered the necessary understanding to know how to get into their dream college, and what extracurriculars, such as academic clubs, sports, and volunteer services to participate in. With class ending off with seniors sharing their personal experiences, ninth graders got a novel teaching on what to expect when applying to college.
Forensic students had to put on their detective gloves last week. Let's turn to Richard Chow for more information.
Last Thursday, Ms. Mary Pico's forensics class was able to put their forensics knowledge to use and experience what it's like to be a real detective.
Thank you.
Starting off, students got to roll their fingerprints onto paper using ink, then using previous knowledge, determined if their prints were a loop, whirl, or arch, and identified the ridge characteristics of their prints. Next, students got the chance to discover their own hidden prints. After placing them on beakers, students uncovered them by dusting them with black powder. They then used tape to pull the powder off the beakers and print it onto paper.
A great detective experience for the class. For the Falcon Report, I'm Richard Chow.
When the Falcon Report returns, we'll learn more about acts of kindness from the South community. But first, a bird's eye view of the Veteran Day themed hallway. The Falcon Report will be right back.
Pseudo-intellectuals do not understand the Pope's psychology.
Perhaps he's better. What's this guy's deal?
It's Charity Mouse. I'm getting my credits from Key Club. I did it!
I did 10,000 steps! I'm in first place!
10,001 steps! First place!
What? Hey, that's not fair.
I got more steps!
Race? Wait for me!
With World Kindness Day happening tomorrow, SAS clubs have been hard at work in preparation for Kindness Week. Creating heartwarming cards and honoring our veterans, students and faculty alike have come together at South in the name of kindness. SAS extracurriculars such as the Kickline team exemplified kindness using their pom-poms, along with the Key Club, who built a vibrant kindness showcase, to name a few.
Let's check in with Emily Nothurb, who had the chance to speak with students and teachers about what kindness meant to them.
Emily?
I stopped to talk to South students about what kindness means to them. What does kindness mean to you?
I think kindness is when you do something nice for someone unprompted.
Going out of your way to help someone out that is either in need or just needs some assistance from you. And it's something that you can do every single day wherever you are.
Giving a little piece of yourself to somebody and it's your true self.
Kindness means everything to me.
Kindness to me is something that can be spread around to everyone.
Kindness is not selective.
When you take the opportunity to step out of your own life and jump into another person's life to provide them with whatever they need.
Demonstrating that you're a caring person to other people.
And what was the time someone was kind to you?
I remember I was walking up one of the staircases and I fell up the stairs onto Mr. C, and I was so embarrassed and I was worried he was gonna be really angry at me. But Mr. C and everyone behind me, they all helped me like pick up my books and help me get up on my feet.
Most of the teachers at South are pretty kind to me. They're very generous and very understanding with their students and very patient.
Teachers are always there to help out, like especially Mr. Lipsky. He's always there after school to like sit down with you with whatever questions you need, and that's just very kind of him.
One of the students stayed to help me clean the room, just out of the goodness of their heart.
To end off our cross-country season, our team, the underclassmen, made both of us posters.
I was going through a particularly rough time in my life, and one of my friends went out of her way to text me and make sure that I was okay and just kept checking in on me, and it was very nice.
A lady on the bus gave me her mom and her umbrella for me to use to walk to school.
Kindness is
being supportive,
being happy, and caring.
Empathy.
Kindness is a smile.
Kindness is small things making a big difference.
And there you have it. Back to you.
Last week gave us no hints, but it's been surprisingly nice this week, with consistently warm temperatures and lots of sun.
Maybe, just maybe, it'll stick this time. But let's check in with the Falcon Report's Isaiah Coombs to find out.
Isaiah?
Compared to this week's warm weather, today will feature the exact opposite, with a small amount of rainfall carrying into the afternoon. Tomorrow will bring on some sun, but both days will be in the low 60s to high 50s. Sunday will feature sun and breeze with highs in the low 50s. All of the days will sport lows between the high 40s and 30s. Endure the weather with a light jacket. Back to you.
As fall sports came to a close last week, cross-country athletes have run ahead of the game, competing for state qualifiers.
Let's turn now to Alina Trzynski to tell us about the results.
Alina?
This year's cross-country team made it all the way to their first state qualifier since the 2019 season. The meet featured the best of Nassau County gathering around at Bethpage State Park. Starting the race off, Jaden Sampson was keeping his pace, taking off with the lead. As captain of the cross-country team, he led the boys with a time of 18 minutes and 34 seconds. Falling behind him was senior Amir Green with a final time of 20 minutes and 50 seconds. On the girls' side of the team, Melissa Gay placed 56th with a time of 26 minutes and 28 seconds. Right behind Melissa was Jeanette Diamond, placing 57th with a time of 26 minutes and 41 seconds. Congrats to the cross-country stars. And that's sports.
That's all for this edition of the Falcon Report. For Saeed Ali, I'm Ibrahim Kadri.
Have a great weekend, South.